Skype for Business is a great adaptation for the work environment of the ever-popular video and voice call tool Skype. Let's look at the basics. If you've downloaded Office 365, you'll already have it, so go to your Applications, search under S, and open it up. The first thing you'll need to do is to set up the audio and video. Open the Tools icon here, go to Tools, and select the Audio Device Setup. For most users, the inbuilt microphone will already be connected and is quite sufficient, so just say a few words to check your audio level. Next, check your video device settings. Most computers these days have an inbuilt camera, but if you're using office equipment, you may have to connect an external camera. Select the camera here and check that it's working properly. Also check the background. It can be embarrassing if you don't get that right. If you can't find your audio or video device, it's worth checking in your control panel to make sure the device is selected. Type control into your search box and select the control panel. For audio, select hardware and sound and manage audio devices. There are two tabs, one for playback to select which speakers to use and one for recording to select which microphone to use. Select the one you want. Again, say a few words to check the audio level and you're done. It's very similar for video. If you can't find the camera, just follow the control panel links, select it and set it up. We're now ready to chat with the colleagues we're working with. They don't have to be in the same town or even the same country, but be careful about time differences. Select the contact you want to check with. In this case, I'm going to ask Jonathan at eTop Technology if he's available for a chat. I can use the inbuilt instant messaging on Skype for Business. I click on the contact and type a quick question. He replies fairly quickly, and I then start my video, which starts the call. You can hear the distinctive calling tone. In this case, Jonathan answers without accepting video, so it's just a voice conversation.
Hey, Richard.
Hi, Jonathan. How is it going?
Oh, it's going pretty good.
Just wanted to check up on that project we were discussing. All going well? He doesn't have the answer I need to hand, so a few minutes later, I ask him to call back. His response shows up in this small window here. And when he calls me back a few moments later with the answer I need, he's using video, and we can discuss the project. Ah, the man himself. I've got the man himself rather than the picture. How are you doing?
Good, how are you?
Okay.
Here we go.
That's excellent. It's really only one step removed from a face-to-face meeting, but without the cost and time of flying from Bangkok to Los Angeles. You can toggle your video feed, audio feed, share your desktop screen, and end the conversation by using these four basic buttons. And if you want to add more than one person so you get a conference call, that's easy using Skype for Business. That's a short introduction to Skype for Business. You can get more detailed help by going to the tool icon, selecting Help, Skype for Business Help, and viewing the training videos. eTop Technology. We're here to help. If you like these videos, please subscribe to our YouTube channel. If you found this video helpful, check out some of our more recent videos. And if you're looking for a new IT partner, please visit our website.